because of that, we have got a particularly large satellite. The Moon is actually the largest natural satellite in comparison to its parent planet in the whole solar system. There are bigger moons out there, but they're going around much bigger planets. So ours is actually the biggest compared to its parent. Now, the Moon has various uses, I suppose. One of the reasons, because it's so large, we think that it's the reason that the dinosaurs lasted as long as they did, and possibly why we lasted as long as we have as well. Because if you've got an object really quite large, quite close to a planet, it can sometimes sort of absorb some of the impacts. So when there's rogue asteroids flying around, the Moon's going to take the hit rather than us. So that could be why life has managed to progress so many times on the Earth. What we call epoch-changing collisions occur approximately once every 50 million years. The last one was 65 million years ago. So we're overdue. Don't have nightmares until we are overdue for another one. Now, the Moon also causes our tides. Basically, we've got the solid rock of the Earth surrounded by a ball of water, which is the oceans, and the Moon's gravity pulls on that orb of water. It's nothing to do with the phases, but when the Moon is at its full phase, it's opposite the Sun, and the Sun also pulls on the Earth's oceans as well, so this is where we get particularly high tides. And of course, as the Earth rotates once every 24 hours, underneath this orb, this stretched orb of water, this is where we get high and low tides twice a day. So, most of us, it doesn't affect us on a day-to-day basis unless we live near the coast. Of course, some of you may have been on holiday to Whipp, the Holy Island. And of course, if you're going to try and head over there, you do need to check the tide tables. This is how you want the road to look when you're trying to cross over to Lancaster. This is not how you want the road to look. So yeah, check your tide tables. The Moon is very important on your holidays. The Moon has been worshipped as a god in many religions over thousands of years. In a lot of religions, they actually regard it to be more significant than the Sun. Because during the day, the Sun's the only thing in the sky. Yes, it's big, it's powerful, it gives us energy. But during the night, the Moon is by far the biggest and the brightest object. And so it's actually revealed to be more of an important thing in various religions. When you get into astronomy, and you buy a telescope or you buy your first pair of binoculars, chances are it's going to be the first thing you want to look at. There's so much to see on there, and as it goes through its phases once every month, all the details are changing as the light falls on in different angles. What are our members? Never stopped looking at the Moon. He first started doing it when he was about 10, he's now well into his 50s now, and he takes incredible photos. Some of the pictures that he's taken from his back garden with his telescope are actually comparable to the ones that Michael Collins took. Michael Collins was at the Moon. Now, the orbit of the Moon around the Earth is not perfectly circular. It's what we call an ellipse, which means that sometimes it comes nearer to us, sometimes a little bit further away. Perigee is the closest approach, apogee is the furthest. And the difference is nearest is about 360,000 kilometres, furthest is 405,000 kilometres, so it's like a 10% difference. Now, when the full Moon coincides with these positions, this is sometimes when the media go crazy and tell you that there's going to be a super moon. To be honest, if they didn't do that, you probably wouldn't notice it was a little bit bigger. If you can compare a super moon to a micro moon, as they're called. There's a whole lot of difference between them, but I'm happy to hop up with the media. If it gets this loud looking at the Moon, I'm happy. But it can affect eclipses. We've already mentioned about eclipses. Now, if the Moon's too far away during a solar eclipse, it isn't large enough in the sky to completely cover the Sun. So what we get is an annular eclipse, which is taken from the Latin annulus, which means ring. I saw one of these in Tunisia a number of years ago, and yeah, not as impressive. to obscure the sun. When it does that, it completely blocks out all of the sun's disk, and you can see the beautiful corona and the prominences around the edge there. I have attempted to see 6 solar eclipses in my lifetime. It's taken me to various tropical places such as Iceland, Cornwall, the Faroe Islands, all of which are cloudy. If you ever want to see a solar eclipse, don't take me with you. But the annular eclipse in Turkey, sorry, in Tunisia, and the total in Turkey, I did see those two. Now, the Moon has often, well, for hundreds of years, been regarded as an object of romance, and many books and poems have been written about the Moon. Don't worry, I'm not about to start citing poetry here. However, it is in music that we are now about to celebrate the Moon, so can we once again show our appreciation for the overall attitude and your remarks.